What if we could create clothing that harnesses the power of synthetic biology in order to create systems that can detect exposure to toxins and pathogens in wearers?
Standard synthetic biology sensors are not compatible in a wearable format, mostly due to storage problems and a dependence on water. Using our shelf-stable, freeze-dried, cell-free reactions and toll-hold switches developed at the Wyss Institute, combined with CRISPR-based Sherlock sensors, we've been able to overcome that barrier, creating the first programmable biohybrid garment.
So we call it the Wearable Freeze-Dried Cell-Free Platform, and it's based on cell-free synthetic biology reactions that we freeze-dried and embedded into flexible materials and textiles. The system is very modular. We can easily reconfigure it to detect different threats. For example, environmental toxins or various pathogens. The platform is essentially a programmable garment that mimics the complex responsive capabilities of the human skin. We've also created distributed fiber optic networks that is integrated with those synthetic biology reactions to make a wearable that continuously scans the user and alerts them when an exposure event is detected.
Well, as one of the proof concepts for our wearable synthetic biology platform, we created these COVID-19 detection face masks, which basically blends two interesting technologies. One that is very quick and versatile, lateral flow immunoassays, with another one that is very sensitive and precise for nucleic acid detection called Sherlock. By combining those two, we're able to provide really accurate results comparable to RT-PCR for detection of SARS-CoV-2. In under 90 minutes, we have essentially shrunk down an entire laboratory testing into a format that can be incorporated into any face mask.
This technology could be incorporated into lab coats for research scientists that work with hazardous materials and pathogens, scrubs for doctors and nurses, or the uniforms of first responders and military personnel who could be exposed to dangerous pathogens or biological weapons, such as nerve gas. We are currently searching for partners who could help develop this to a production stage product. We believe that inexpensive, rapid, and sensitive wearable sensors could greatly improve the safety of those at risk for exposure to dangerous pathogens and toxins.